Can you hear me? Yes, okay. This one's called 901 Walnut. Yes, that's my address. Don't show up in the middle of the night unless you like bring pizza or something. Please, just forget that address. Okay. Can you call me? Sorry, that was funny. Can you call me tonight after the landlord's been by to check out the furnace? Mansplaining how the heater works, and his 20-year-old whore has finished holding the flashlight for him, with her jeans riding low on her hips and that lost look in her eyes, silent the whole time. And me just wondering how she ever got there, how she ever fucks that man with the droopy face, parasitic hands, and gruff stare. Can you call me tomorrow after the moon is up and the radio's playing that song you like and the people who live with me go out for the day? When the weather's fair, but not too fair, but not that bad either, and the dogs are barking at the two squirrels fighting along the trunk of a tree in drunk spirals. While I'm cleaning the bright orange bird poop, making a real Jackson Pollock shit masterpiece on my car. Can you call me your friend after we smashed the skull of that mouse that got into the walnuts? And you left the brick on top of its head for days, a grave marker, its little body sticking out, still in the spine-breaking trap, stiff and without funeral. I wonder if you kill everything like that, in such a grisly and queasy way, waiting for someone else to clean up the mess you can't stand to look at. The trash is getting picked up on Tuesday. The mouse is in there. I tied it in a plastic bag. Its frozen body made a louder thump than I was expecting. It's important to put the can out last minute so the wind doesn't tip it over and scatter all the trash across the street. But there's a class I have to get to, and I was hoping you'd call so I could give you the garage key and you can wheel it down the drive for me. Or is yesterday the last I hear from you?